Is this lighting strange? I think so. But I'm not gonna move it. So, new video time with Tom. Okay, so what I've been realizing that I've been doing and I should do, I haven't been really introducing myself in the videos. Well, I'm Tom. My name is Tom, and I live in America. I am from Connecticut, and that's all I'm gonna say because I don't want you guys to stalk me. Okay, so here we go, new video time. Okay, so what I'm gonna be talking about today is an article that I read on our website, psych2go.net, about friends with benefits and what do experienced individuals and studies conclude about this. Well, basically, you guys have heard about the new movie, well, not really new, it came out like 3 or 4 years ago, the movie called Friends with Benefits, which features Mila Kunis and Justin Timberlake. They brought this sort of a common complexity to light. Is that a good way to put it? I thought so. So basically in the movie, you know how towards the end they kind of are like, oh my god, I love you, I want to be with you forever, like, and then they're like, wait, no, but we just wanted to have sex. Well, that kind of Friends with Benefit relationships often experience this happening when they're unable to tell the difference between their emotions for the other person and simply the sex. Now, obviously, one of the main questions is, do they work? Well, a friends with benefit relationship is defined as a sexual relationship between two friends who are not emotionally committed to one another. So obviously it's just for sex. It's not intimate emotionally, it's intimate physically. These relationships are obviously hard to observe, and therefore there's not a lot of research or studies to kind of back it up. But Match.com did a study saying that, and they concluded that half of the college population currently or previously have engaged in a friends with benefit relationship, as well as 47% of single people have previously engaged in a friends with benefit relationship. And that's why when it comes to friends with benefits situations, these lines are often blurred all the time, and it becomes hard to distinguish emotions from libido. Now, Kendra Knight, a communications professor at a university in America, I'm not sure what university, conducted a study that proved qualitative results, which means it's just descriptive results. She noticed that a pattern of these relationships failed. And her study concluded that both parties agreed communication is vital, but that they don't really need it. It was never really developed in this friends with benefit situation. And the reason that these relationships failed is because talking about the relationship defeats the purpose of the entire situation, the relationship. Because if you're friends with benefits, you don't want to say, oh, how was your day? You know, you thinking about getting a dog? Yes, me too. I'm having a hard time at work. No, you meet up and, you know, you do your thing and then you go your separate ways. Like, power to you. If you can make it work, you do you. But, like, that's not what this is about at all, and it defeats the entire purpose of the relationship. The students don't want to seem clingy or insecure if they open up about it. So, one quick thing for you guys is, why don't you let us know in the comments below what, if you know anyone, or if you yourself have ever been in a friends with benefits situation. You know, tell us how it went with the other person or yourself, and why do you think it went that way? We're pretty curious as to know what happened. So, thank you guys for watching so much. Be sure to check out the article on psych2go.net. Be sure to check out our Tumblr, which is psych2go as well on Tumblr. And you can find me at my little social media links, which are linked below. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Love you. Mwah. Bye.